Hello and welcome back. I have finished this new journal. Finally, it took a while to finish it because it was a lot of work. It was super fun, but it was a lot of work. I really did a lot in this journal for this journal. So it took a while. It's a big dude, chunky and it is a hardcover journal, but I haven't just repurposed an old book cover. I have used book boards, and then I built this cover. Tok, tok, tok. So, chunky, big, fat dude. So, let me show you here all this. Oh, this is, it was, it is special. It is very special. I'll show you in a moment why. I think everything is special. I had really fun. So lots of lace, vintage lace, lots of pom-poms, lots of sari ribbon. It has a tassel that is completely removable if you don't think it matches, so you can very easily remove it. Vintage lace, the underneath, this is not vintage, but it's lace. Pom-poms everywhere. We all love pom-poms. Here, this flower is from this vintage lace. I turn it around. I have used this, we call it here a faux velvet. It's soft, black with very gorgeous ornaments, and I have sewn completely around 3 times so that it doesn't fray. The closure is set with eyelets, lots of lace, gorgeous. So, and here I have given these flowers also a pom-pom, single pom-pom here on top. I've glued it down. Here you can see with this, this is completely removable. I need to show you this a little bit closer. So, and I made here a teeny tiny collage with this Japan-themed picture here on top, framed by pom-poms and this lace flower. Let me show you the tassel that comes with this journal. If you don't like it, or if you think it doesn't match this journal, you can easily remove it because it's just clipped with this clippy thingy to the spine. It has lace, the same lace that I have used in this journal. Some more lace. This is not vintage. This is vintage. Light pink, very light pink, hand-dyed sari ribbon, off-white sari ribbon. Again, here's some pom-poms. Gold beige eyelash trim. Very light pink eyelash trim, white eyelash trim, and this here, this beet purple beet glass bead thing ding ding, and here are some more. Now come on, some more beads dangling. So I remove this for this flip through. Then I can, don't know if I can show you this. Here are lots of beads hanging out. This always the center strips from the signatures. 3 signatures, 168 pages. It measures, it's really chunky and big. It measures 8 3/4 by 6.5 and a 2.5. Two and no what? 2 1/4 inch spine. So it's big. A B. Lots of things in there. I think I it was fun. So it opens up like this. Let me show you again here. All this rum, 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 rum. I'm excited. So it opens up like this on the inside from the same fabric like the outside cover is. I have made these pockets, from this vintage lace, this flower, and a pom-pom here on top. The inside is also fabric, that I've just coffee dyed. And I made this tag, the big tag, also here with lace and pom-poms. I've backed it to some coffee stained cardstock. And here this is also cardstock with a pattern, some lace dingle ding dong, a little bit of vintage music and book page in the background, and here an Japan themed image. So you can journal in them. I really think you can journal in it. So this is one of the main pages, and here's a pocket. I have printed my own, no, I have scanned my own avocado dyed paper, and then I printed it on the backside of these pages. So this is printed avocado dyed. Here I have backed this, this is an image from Mrs. Cox. I have used Luise Heinzel and Mrs. Cox images. So I mounted it on cardstock that I had in my stash. And here this is from this fabric from the outside. So we have here tags I have included here. Then the tag pocket. And I thought that matches also the theme of Japan. So here's a little, I have shrunk down some things to have more possibilities. And this is so cute, this little guy. This is original avocado dyed paper, and I have punched it here with my edge punch. Here's this vintage lace. A little pocket here in the corner, and I have put this little tickets here. You can journal here a little bit on the back side. Maybe an inspirational word. So this belly band here is wallpaper. I found some wallpaper. I've stained it then because it was lighter than this one. I've stained it with walnut stain, I think. And here's a little card. And here a little collage here as a focal point. Here I've just glued a little ticket that I had left. This little scallop pocket thingy. Here a mini tiny tag. Like I said, I have shrunk down the elements here. And this flips out. Gorgeous new page. And here you can see the first special thingies that I have added are beads, glass beads on the paper clip. Because this tag I made with this image from Mrs. Cox, some pattern cardstock, some layering in the background. It's just clipped here with this beads dingly ding dong thingy, avocado dyed paper, coffee stained paper, and I have laid lace on top, and then I have dried it in the sun. It smells also like coffee, I have to say that. Here, pom-pom trim on the edge, side pocket. I have made here, you can use it as a bookmark or journaling spot. And here, I have printed some of the images on vellum. Then I have sealed the vellum with an acrylic sealer spray. And then I have backed it with a vintage book page, then with coffee stained paper. And then I have here added this beads dingly ding dong. This is a stenograph vintage page, avocado dyed grid paper. This pocket is a completely fold out. You know this already from my previous videos, the idea from Terry Wood. And I've used this here. It's a journal card. So you can see here in the background, this is the pattern card stock. Pretty beige. I hope everybody is doing well. So here in this pocket, I have cut out a tag with this other shapes. That's shape like this tags here. And then I have added this image sewn around and this pom-pom ding-a-ling-dongs here on top. Sari ribbon. Here, this I think this is a cute idea to have here this tags. I like it. So, pretty page. Printed avocado dyed pattern. No, my scanned avocado dyed paper I have printed here on the back side. And now here's another very special thingy. This is the first center of this is the first center of the first signature. Oh, I cannot talk today. I show you first the tag here. And here again one of the paper clips with beads dingly ding dong. And now I show you that this is wallpaper and it opens up like ta-da this. I show you this closer. Isn't that gorgeous? Oh, I found this in my stash, this page. This is very shiny, very delicate. This matches so well to this kit, and I needed to use it. Wallpaper, it's gorgeous. And here I can show you now here the first dingly ding dongs with the beads that are hanging here on the bottom out of the journal, so it's not in the way. Look at this page. Awesome. avocado dyed printed. Here's the back side of this tag thingies. I like this idea. Here is a pocket triple thingy pocket from wallpaper. Also a little bit dyed darker. This here is just a little booklet with some additional papers. It's a tag I made with this image from Mrs. Cox. And here you can see this is darker. Then you have here a little bit lighter. This was the original color. So I dyed this darker and you can see it maybe. This is elements. This is gorgeous, really gorgeous. And I have added here a little extra. And here in the back, there's another journal card backed on cardstock. It's a little bit shiny, the cardstock here in the background. So lots of room for writing, and also lots of room. I let a lot of room for when you glue things down. Sari ruffle. Here another one of these little pockets. And a mini journal card, avocado dyed paper, ding 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 ding, ding. Again a little pocket, and here I have put this ticket in there. I think that will become a longer video. So here I have added this, and floats out completely. So you have a spot for hidden journaling. It's gorgeous. The paper is gorgeous. Again, vintage lace. Little pocket with this image. These are the birds from the center. Again, one of these tags. I have coffee stain. It was just black and white, and now it's black, white, gray, and coffee stain. But I think it reminded me on Japan. Don't know why. So here comes the second signature. Again, I like these pockets, and this mini, tiny. Tag. Again, avocado dyed paper, and here another special. I have printed one of the pages on vellum, sealed it with an acrylic sealer, coffee stained with pom-poms. Here's a bag from parchment paper with this paper clip, just a little thingy. And I have put a little booklet that I had left here into it. I fix it later. Journal card. This here is in another language. This was from a book from Yugoslavia, but it's cooking receipts. So no bad words. This bothers me now. I need to put it back. So come on. So here you can see it. And I let this because sometimes you want to glue something down, so you have a whole page where you can glue something on top if you like. Another pocket from wallpaper. I have included these two thingies, tag and journal card. Here you can see it again, this shiny wallpaper with this pattern. This was the original color, and to have it a little bit, how do you call it? Different. I say not different. Contrast. To have a contrast, I have let a piece in the original color. Tag I made. Little mini tiny journal card. Avocado dyed paper, original. This original avocado dyed paper I always have punched with my edge punch. This is a spot for hidden journaling. It's a flip and it's fun. Here in the corner I have this scalloped circle. I put this little tiny tag in there, and you can flip this completely up for hidden journaling. You can also use it as a belly band. When you glue it here down, then you can tuck something behind. And I thought I'd let it this way. Avocado dyed paper, sari ruffle on coffee stained paper, grid paper. Here also I have included this into all signatures. This is fun. It's just fun. So, and this is the super trooper mambo jumbo mega special thing. This, the center of the second signature of this three, it is original, it is unique, it is old, it's awesome. It is this. This here is an original silk painting, and this is awesome. This is incredible. Original, unique, one of a kind, old. My mother received this from a friend. And her, was it the father? I think so. The father of the friend of my mother has painted this ages ago. It is original painting. It is not printed, nothing. This is original, unique. My mother received this as a gift. And when my mother passed away, I have received it. And I had to include it here. So this is really original draw painting on silk, this Japanese silk painting, this motif, this is, I really love it. Dude. Another one of this, sorry, I had to show it again. I'm a little bit impressed of this piece, I must say that. So very special. A tag clipped to the page with a little beat dangly ding dong here. And this is a fold-out pocket, but it also included some goodies, another paper clip with a bling bling heart. This folds out, then you can get this. This is from an old vintage book. It is not avocado dyed. I haven't avocado dyed it. This was in a book, like it is. In a vintage book from, what was it, 1924, I believe. I saw this piece here. So I've used it, added some lace here, and this image. And here in the background, there's also lace. And one more of this pages printed on vellum, sealed with acrylic sealer from both sides. Added some vintage music, vintage book page behind, and then I have backed it with coffee stained paper, and I also made here this beat dingly ding dong, and so on, of course. So this folds completely out. So yes, it's a lot in this journal. Oopsie. Okay. So now clip it correctly together again. So now I have it. Oh, and here this is a bling heart. Little pocket. Mini pocket. Vintage lace. Avocado dot paper. Here again, one of the tags I made with images from Mrs. Cox. I haven't added here a bead. I will do it. I will include here a bead dingle ding dong. A pocket, and here some, yeah, this is, it looks like a mini bookmark. It is cardstock, and then I've added this writing here. Sewn around, so you can journal here as inspirational word maybe on behind. So that's absolutely possible. Tag pocket, this time with this tag I made, and here a belly band again with wallpaper, and then here this image I have added. I've attached on another piece of cardstock. So I used a lot of pattern cardstock to put these images on top. A little collage I made. That's big fish. Super fun fish. It was a public domain. This is the other side from the parchment paper bag. I don't open it now. There's also a journal card in there. The other side from the vellum. Larger tag or bookmark thingy. And here comes the third signature. Journal card backed with patterned cardstock. This patterned cardstock again. Little card. Avocado dyed paper, coffee stained paper with sari ruffle. Again, I liked to use a lot of this large small tags. No, that's wrong. This larger tags that are not so wide. And this is also a flip out mini tag. Also gorgeous page. Belly band from the wallpaper and journal card behind. Avocado dyed paper. Coffee stained paper with vintage lace. And this is a tuck. And here again, one of this vellum, printed on vellum, sealed it with acrylic sealer, vintage music, vintage book page in the background, and then backed with coffee stain paper. And here again, shorthand, vintage shorthand page. And again, a fold-out pocket. Like I said, I really like to do this with this larger, longer thingies. If you call this now a tag and this is a bookmark, it's okay. This is from the fabric from the cover. And here this tag. Ooh, sorry. It folds out completely, this pocket. Another journal card. And here's the third very special thingy for me, at least. It's again a wallpaper piece. The tag here behind. And ta-da! It's gorgeous. Gorgeous. And it's shiny. So it looks a little bit... I think at least it looks a little bit like silky wallpapery, shiny. And the birds here, it's awesome. That, yeah, now you can see it here, shiny, shiny. It is really awesome. It has again here this bead dangly ding dongs here hanging out of the center. It's, I was so happy that I found this wallpaper and I thought, oh. Use it wise. And then I thought, why? Wise? Use it at the center. Here, two little thingies to, in this pocket. Another tag. Shorthand page. Coffee stain page with pom-poms, avocado dyed, again a pocket from wallpaper, here original color, and I colored this darker, you can see this shiny from these elements here. So there's lots of stuff in this journal, little ticket. Folds out. Good. This says the tea house. Sorry, ruffle. Little tag. One more of this. Guys, I think it looks like it belongs into this journal. And here again, this vellum with vintage book page, and here some beads dingling. And here on this paper clip, there's also this beads, and that's the back. Here again, a large tag, and this little tag, and this fabric from the cover, and then here from this vintage lace, the flower and a pom-pom here in the middle. This was so much fun. It's full, it's chunky, but I really love to do this. It's very special, very unique. Remember the original unique silk painting, and I think it's, it's maybe 50 years old or older, I don't know exactly. So, with a gorgeous tassel, if you don't like this tassel, you can remove it. But this is gorgeous. I think I'm super proud of it. I think you hear it in my voice. Was fun. Was really, really fun. So, I hope you like it. I hope it finds a new home soon. Thank you for watching. Have a fabulous weekend. Bye.